Hey, Free Life families. My name is Miss Genesis, and this week is our last and final week learning all about the miracles of Jesus. We've been learning about the impossible things he can do for us and how he's big and strong. Let's go ahead and get ready for worship by standing up nice and tall. This week's Bible story, we're going to see a miracle that Jesus did by healing a blind man. This means he could not see at all. Let's go ahead and watch that Bible story.
Stories of the Bible. Jesus heals a man born blind. This is Jesus.
Heyo!
Who is the Son of God and the Savior of the world. While Jesus was on earth, he taught everyone about God's love. He did many miracles and healed people of their sickness.
Oh, hey, everyone!
One day, Jesus was walking with his disciples, and he saw a man who was born blind.
Hey, Jesus!
His disciples wondered whose fault it was. That this man was blind, Jesus told them it was not because anyone sinned, but rather it was because the power of God could be shown through this man's life. Then Jesus spit on the ground and made mud. He spread the mud over the blind man's eyes and told him, "Go wash yourself in the pool of Siloam." So the man went and did as Jesus said, and he could see. The man's neighbors and others who knew him as the blind man wondered if this was the same man.
Is that the same guy?
No way.
They said, "No, he just looks like him."
Right.
No, it can't be.
But the blind man kept saying, "Yes, it's me. So the people asked, "Who healed you? What happened?" And the man told them all that Jesus had done for him.
Well, that's what happened.
The people asked, "Where is Jesus now?" But the man didn't know.
Come on, you know.
So the people took the man to the Pharisees because it was the Sabbath, the day of rest, and they thought Jesus shouldn't have made mud and healed the man on the Sabbath. The Pharisees asked the man so many questions.
What's going on?
And he answered them, "I was blind, but now I can see." The Pharisees kept asking more questions. They even brought the man's parents in to ask them questions, but they wouldn't answer because they were afraid of the Pharisees. Finally, the man had enough and yelled,
Listen!
"Look, I told you once. Why do you want to hear it again? If this man were not from God, he couldn't have made me see." The Pharisees were so mad at the man for saying this that they threw him out of the synagogue. Jesus heard what happened.
Oh, hey there.
And he found the man and asked him, "Do you believe in the Son of Man?" The man answered, "Who is he, sir? I want to believe in him." "You have seen him," Jesus said, "and he is speaking to you."
Wow!
"Yes, Lord, I believe." And he worshiped Jesus.
What an amazing Bible story. As we watched, we met a man who could not see. He's been blind his entire life, but when he met Jesus, Jesus healed him. This means he was able to see again. He was so excited about what Jesus did for him that he wanted to tell everybody. He told his friends and he told his family. And this Bible story teaches us that we can do the same thing. Jesus wants us to share all the good things that he's done for us. And that brings us to our big idea.
It's the big idea.
We can tell everyone about the good things Jesus has done for us. So remember this week that anytime Jesus does something good for you, to share it with your family and friends. Just like the blind man, he was so excited and he wanted to tell everybody. Jesus wants us to tell our friends and our family how much we love him and all the great things he's done for us. Now let's go ahead and end this video in prayer so everyone watching, bow your heads and close your eyes. Jesus, thank you so much for every amazing thing you have done for me and for everyone watching. Help us to always trust in you and to tell everyone about the amazing things you have done for us. We love you so much and we pray these things in your name. Amen. Now let's all watch one more video.
Pastor Steve! Ha! This is awesome! I'm so excited! Yay, science!
Hi, everyone! Welcome back to Mad Science Skills with Pastor Steve, where I, Pastor Steve, am going to teach you some mad science skills. Science is the future, and I'm bringing the future to you with my mad science skills. Check this out! It's me! Pretty awesome, right? I had 10,000 of these bad boys rush delivered to my science lab, and they're on the way right now. I know what you're thinking, though. You're thinking, this shirt is so awesome. It's so good. You need to share it with the rest of the world. And I know you're right. Don't worry. I'm already way ahead of you. That's exactly why I made this custom t-shirt cannon. I call it the Blast-O-Matic 5000.
The Blast-O-Matic 5000!
With this bad boy, I'm going to launch my t-shirts all around the world. To have enough power to reach all the way around the world, I have to have a supercharger on this thing. And you know, a little of the, little of this, little of that, some fairy dust here, a little nuclear power there.
Nuclear power!
And that's how we do it on Mad Science Skills! But before we share my new t-shirts with the rest of the world, I want to tell you about someone who shared something even more awesome with the rest of the world in the Bible. They shared the good news of Jesus. Now, let me tell you about this blind man that Jesus healed. One day, Jesus and his disciples were walking along, and they came across a man who was blind. His disciples asked Jesus why the man was blind. They thought his blindness was because he had sinned or his parents had sinned. But Jesus said, no, it was not because of his sins or his parents' sins. This happened just so that the power of God could be seen through him. Whoa! Jesus said that the man's blindness was planned just so the power of God could work through him. That's a revolutionary way to show the world that God is truly all-powerful. So, you're probably wondering, did Jesus heal him? Did the man ever see again? You bet he did. And the way that Jesus healed the man defies all laws of science. It's a true miracle. Do you guys remember what a miracle is? A miracle is basically something that Jesus does that is so amazing, you know that no ordinary person could have done it. Okay, back to our story. Jesus spit on the ground and made mud from the dirt and his saliva. Now, obviously, I'm just gonna use water because I'm not Jesus and it would just be gross if I spit in the dirt. And then Jesus spread the mud all over the man's eyes. Like this. After that, Jesus told the man to go wash in the pool of Siloam, which means sent. When the man did exactly what Jesus said to do, he could see. It was a miracle. The power of God working through him to make the blind man see again. Amazing, right? I have a towel somewhere. So, what should we do about all this amazing knowledge we have about Jesus' miracles during his earthly ministry and the amazing things he continues to work in our lives today? Well, I'll tell you. Jesus wants us to share the good news with everybody that we can. He wants us to tell people that God loves them and he wants to save them through his plan in Jesus. Just like I'm gonna share these super awesome t-shirts with the world because I know everyone wants a t-shirt with my face on it. Jesus wants us to share his love. He wants us to tell others about the good things God has done in our lives and that he can work in their lives too. Okay, I have to connect the reactor to the nuclear fission simulator that will then allow. It's connected. Okay. Okay, the t-shirt cannon is powering up. But one thing I forgot to tell you is that this t-shirt cannon is powered by science.
Science!
Don't worry, nothing can possibly go wrong. Scientifically speaking, this t-shirt cannon is going to break the sound barrier. Yeah, that's right. Because my hypothesis is that it's going to cause a miniature sonic boom.
Sonic boom!
Inside my science lab. It's going to be awesome.
So awesome!
This cannon works simply by taking the air and hyper-compressing it, by squeezing as much air as we possibly can into this chamber. Now, once the air is compressed, it wants to escape. And all I have to do is push this little button and it releases the air, launching my t-shirt into space. But first, we have to compress it. I have just initiated the compression sequence. We want to achieve a PSI of at least 200. PSI stands for pounds per square inch. 25 PSI and counting. 30 PSI and counting. Woo! Listen to that baby purr! We're at 50 PSI. All right, now the only thing left to do is to launch this t-shirt into outer space. Mad science skills! All right, the cannon is loaded. Let's do this. 3, 2, 1. Thank you. t-shirt put a hole in my science lab, but that's okay. As awesome as these experiences are, nothing can compare to God's awesome power and the miracles that he can do in our life. We love you guys, and we'll see you next time. Now I'm gonna go reload my cannon and launch some more t-shirts. Mad Science Skills!